Please help me welcome Ambassador Arazov and his wife Irina Borisovna.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Turkmenistan is independence and neutrality. Turkmenistan gained its independence on October 1991 as a result of disintegration of Soviet Union and started on its new path as a young country and a very old nation. One of the most important decisions our young country made was the declaration of neutrality of Turkmenistan that occurred during a special session of United Nations on December 12, 1995, 20 years ago. Our country declared its neutrality on the international arena in the very first years of its independence. It is the first time in the practice of United Nations that the status has been given to the country via a special UN resolution with the name Permanent Status of Turkmenistan, Neutrality of Turkmenistan, and later reference in the first article of UN Basic Principles. That is our flag. The second picture is a presidential standard, special emblem. Later we will see very similar emblem from the Seljuk Empire time with some kind of modification which was made by modern Turkmenistan as our state emblem of Turkmenistan. There are a lot of questions about this unusual flag. And I will tell you that this red line consists of five different girls. It's ornament from our Turkmen cartons. And you will ask why these five? Because we have many tribes from the history, but the major tribes, five, is Ahaltseke, Yomut, Salir, Chordur, and Sarvi. And to show that we are united, that we are all together, we put this on the flag, symbolize our unity. The first one is Ahaltseke, first one, second is Yomut, Salir, third one, Chordur, fourth, and the last one is Ersavi. Couple of views of modern Ashwaba. What you will see on these pictures in the city is all built in the years of independence. This is presidential palace, a new one. That is Stella in the same place. That is our stele for neutrality, which was built to honor the status of Turkmenistan as a neutral status. On the top of this statue is a statue of our first president, Sapar Murat Niyazov. That is just our modern streets in Ashgabat. By the way, Turkmenistan is in the Guinness Book as the white city, because we are number one in the world having this marble buildings. That's a difference. That is a wedding palace. unusual construction. Maybe it reflects that marriage is a very complicated sense. With Stella and Honor Our Horses, again different kind of archaeological construction. And this pictures of two of the most prestigious hotels. One is Aguskenta and another one is Yildiz, which if you translate means the star. That is our horses. And the name of these horses is Ahaltsike horse. It's a very famous breed, very famous breed, very well recognized in the world. Now look at this. There is a legend, of course, difficult to say it's true or not, but Alexander the Great had a horse, it was the name of Bucephal. And there is a legend that it was exactly a Halsikia horse breed. And I would want to show you a couple of examples of our carpets. You see this Ahaltsike, and look for this on ornaments. It's the Ahaltsike design which you saw on the outline. It's the same Ahaltsike. This is Yamut design, Yamut carpets. These are Sari carpets. Salir and Chevdur. Turkmenistan is also famous to make portraits and different kind of pictures, not only classical designs. So that's an example of our first cosmonaut of the world, Yuri Gagarin. Not him. And this first picture of the horses. I would say you that now in modern Turkmenistan, this part of business is flourishing. A lot of different kind of portraits, different pictures, and so on, is going very well. And that is cultural items from these ancient civilizations. For example, this one. Like this one, you can find in the Metropolitan Museum in New York, in the section of ancient Asia. That is a very famous item, a gold head of the bull. That is excavation in Margush, 3000 BC. Very interesting items which show that culture was developed pretty well in those age of time. But the written history, the history haven't been fixed, the history haven't been fixed in documents, starts only from the middle of the first millennium BC, when the Turkmen land was a part of Achaemenid's power, where Zoroastrianism was a dominating religion. By the end of the 4th century, Alexander the Great crossed the territory with his army, having left the conquered countries to his successor, Seleucides, as a heritage. And in the middle of the 3rd century BC, the Persian kingdom was founded at the full heath of the Kapit Dagh. And that is very interesting because it's very much related to our territory. And I will show you a map. And that is the Persian Empire, and at its highest level of development, not from the beginning, but the beginning started here in this tiny place, Nisa, which is 10 kilometers from Ashgabat, and was formed by some groups of powerful military men from Herzman and some elites from Persia. Slowly this became so big, so big. And imaginably its empire existed from BC to 224 AD, 470 years. At the time it was the second empire in the world after the Roman Empire. And they compete with each other for many years. And the highest level of this Persian Empire was, I would say, between 70 BC to maybe 100 AD. That is the most interesting part. August tribes, you see, this Caspian Sea, Aral Sea, all of this, and other Khaganates, it's also Turkic, goes to the Kazakhstan. All of this Khaganate is also Kazakhstan. Here it was Khazar Khaganate, also very interesting. But all of them was not Islam, it was pagans. Pagans mixed with Christianity, with Jewish religion, and later was interfered by Islam. And from this place, one famous tribe went down it happened in the 10th century and the beginning of 11th century. This 11th century was commemorated by the birth of powerful centralized empire, having been founded by Turkmen Seljuks, resulting from the brilliant military victories. You see this emblem? What we have now, it was two heads, but now we have five. These two heads show that empire was looking in two directions, and the east and the west. And our five heads show that we don't look and watch anything, we just look inside. And these five heads show that we have five vilayas and all this unity. But the idea is taken from here, it's 11th century. And you see the size of this empire, it's unbelievable. Seljuk Empire, and it has very serious influence. After this born here, slowly they moved, and finally they have the capital in Isfahan, in modern Iran. Some tribes from Turkmenistan moved to the India, and you see this Kutub Minar is in Delhi, which was built by first Turkmen Sultan, and it's second highest minar, or minaret, we say, in Delhi. The tallest one in Punjab province, this you see, built also by Turkey group, but not Turkmen. And this is the highest in Central Asia minar in Kunyavur Genç, which was built also in 16th century by Turkmen dynasty. Thank you very much for your time.